Hi, this is Joe Hage from Medical Marcom, and I have the pleasure of being with my friend Michael Paquin. He is a fellow of HIMSS, that's the Health Information Management System Society. Is that right?
Correct.
I remember what the acronym stands for. Michael is an expert relating to EMR connectivity, meaningful use, and the pitfalls of both. So Michael, please tell my readers a little bit about exactly that.
I think if we're looking at physicians today and trying to look and address some of their problems that they're having in their offices and what they're afraid of in purchasing an electronic medical record, I think we have to start with the beginning, and that is service and implementation. I want to empower all the physicians that are out there to really take the vendors that they're working with and really make them give them the service that they need. Getting an EMR is only one part of the puzzle in being successful in achieving your meaningful use dollars. The meaningful use dollars over a five-year period can add up to about $48,000 to $64,000, depending if you're Medicare or Medicaid. But what you really need to think about is that purchase price and negotiate it well. Don't overspend, but do overspend, if you will. I know that's contradictory, but do overspend when it comes to implementation and training. A lot of doctors will purchase an electronic medical record and think that they can have the training done in 3 days. And what I'd like you to think about for just a moment is if each and every one of you just bought Microsoft Office and brought it into your practice for the first year or first training, could you get trained on PowerPoint, Outlook, Word, Excel, all the different features of Microsoft Office in 3 days while you're not seeing patients, while you are seeing patients? Can you train all three, four nurses in your office? What does that mean? So what I'm suggesting to you is take the time to get trained so that you can use the products correctly. What I'm seeing out in the marketplace is that doctors are starting to go with their second or third vendor for their electronic medical record software because they had an unsuccessful first blush with vendor A or vendor B. They weren't trained. All of these systems have workflow issues. All of them are trying to be addressed, and all of them are trying to get better. None of them is going to be perfect, but what's going to make a perfect EMR installation for you is the training. Make sure that you negotiate all the prices. Make sure that you buy from a vendor that is certified by the ONC. And make sure that you've got that certification. Certification means that when you go at the end of the day, or at the end of the year, if you will, to get your meaningful use dollars, that you can show your product was certified. So there's a lot to getting ready for purchasing an EMR. There's a lot to choosing the right vendors. Make sure that you get in touch with a consultant that can help you. There's a lot of lessons learned that will pay for a consultant's time. So anyway, in this installation of this first video, I think we've covered enough, but feel free to contact me with any questions.
So I'll paraphrase. When you choose an EMR partner, make sure that they're one that's going to be around and one that can provide you with the level of training you need.
And certified.
And certified. Michael, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm.